The presence of lead itself is not the issue. To actually determine lead levels, you have to do a 24-hour soak in a 4% acetic acid solution with a laboratory analysis, following ASTM C738. All the documentation can be found with the FDA and their compliance policy guide, CPG545.450. But I'll save you the pain. What are the allowable levels? The FDA states that for flatware, that's things like plates and bowls, you can have 3 milligrams per liter of lead release when soaked in that 4% acetic acid solution for 24 hours. Then the numbers go down depending on the shape of the pot. Hollowware is slightly lower, and cups and mugs and pitchers have the value that most people associate, which is 0.5 milligrams per liter. Now, why are cups and mugs and pitchers different? In the past, people didn't buy and store their food in plastic containers like we do today. They would buy things like orange juice in a glass container, then pour that into their own pitcher, which they would leave in the refrigerator. That juice has citric acid in it that would then be left for periods of days or longer. As they would eventually drink the juice, they would then consume lead that was extracted from the acid in the juice from the poorly composed or fired glazes. Something like a plate, on the other hand, our food is in contact with that for 10 to 30 minutes, and you eat the food and it's gone. So your food's relationship with that dish is very, very different from an extraction standpoint. Much less the fact that food that goes on plates tends to be much less acidic than things like orange juice or something else that might go into a cup or a mug. But at the end of the day, it's okay to have lead in glazes as long as it's designed, fired, and tested properly. Let's be clear, there is no such thing as interacting with materials in the world that have a zero chemical impact. That's just not how chemistry works. The question is, what amounts have a negative impact on human beings? And that's what the FDA and appropriate testing is for. That's the science, and all the fearmongers can get lost as far as I'm concerned.